Welcome back. Investing can be a confusing and intimidating process for many people, especially those who are new to it. On one hand, the potential for high returns can be tempting, but on the other hand, the fear of losing money can be overwhelming. Understanding the psychology of investing can help you make more informed decisions and avoid emotional pitfalls. Let's begin. Today, we'll explore the various psychological factors that come into play when investing, how they can affect your investment outcomes, and some simple things we can do to be more cognizant of these biases. Investing is a way to grow your money over time, allowing you to achieve financial independence and reach your long-term financial goals. It's important to understand that investing involves taking calculated risks with the aim of earning higher returns than if your money was simply left in, say, a savings account or a bond fund. Investing in the stock market can be both exciting and nerve-wracking. One of the biggest obstacles to successful investing is the presence of psychological biases and emotions. These biases can cause investors to make impulsive decisions that may not align with their long-term investment goals. Here are a few common psychological biases that investors face. One of the biggest psychological factors that comes into play when investing is fear and greed. Fear of losing money can prevent you from making investment decisions, while greed can lead you to make hasty and unwise decisions. It's important to find a balance between these two emotions and make decisions based on sound reasoning and research, and enter positions that consider the downside risk so as to not concentrate your capital on any one position. A huge hurdle that can hinder people as they gain experience in the stock market is becoming too greedy after a string of wins or too avert to risk after getting burned. Putting these emotions aside when making buy and sell decisions may lead to better investment outcomes. Moving on to anchoring bias, which refers to the tendency for people to rely too heavily on the first piece of information they receive. This can lead to a biased perspective on the value of a particular investment and can lead to incorrect investment decisions. Anchoring bias can also occur when investors have an emotional attachment to a stock or have previously made significant gains from it. In these cases, the investor may be anchored to the stock's past performance and ignore any potential risks or warning signs, leading to poor investment decisions. I'm reminded of many times that I've made a successful trade on a particular company, only to continue trading that company again and again, ignoring any new evidence that may contradict my initial reasoning, and eventually giving up all the gains I made to begin with. To avoid anchoring bias in investing, it's important to gather as much information as possible about a stock before making an investment decision. This can include analyzing financial statements, reading company news and reports, and even going as far as consulting with a trusted financial professional. Additionally, having a well-diversified portfolio and taking a long-term investment horizon can help reduce the impact of anchoring bias by reducing the risk of putting too much emphasis on a single stock. If you get your analysis wrong, at least you're diversified enough to not impact your portfolio significantly. Moving on to confirmation bias, which is the tendency to look for information that confirms your existing beliefs while ignoring information that contradicts them. This can lead to a false sense of confidence in your investment decisions and can lead to losses if you're not considering all of the relevant information. Investors who exhibit confirmation bias may be more likely to seek out information that supports their investments and ignores information that suggests their investments may not be as sound as they believe. They may also be more likely to believe anecdotal evidence or rumors that support their investments while disregarding credible sources of information that suggest otherwise. This can lead to a situation where investors hold on to losing investments for too long, or where they miss out on investment opportunities because they ignore information that contradicts their beliefs. For example, an investor that believes in a particular stock may ignore negative news about the company or industry and focus on positive news. They may also ignore warnings from financial experts or ignore conflicting evidence that suggests that their investment may not be as profitable as they had hoped. As a result, they may miss out on opportunities to sell their investments and avoid losses, or to invest in more promising opportunities. To avoid confirmation bias in investing, it's important to be open-minded, objective, and impartial, and to consider all relevant information, regardless of whether it supports your existing beliefs. This can be achieved by seeking out multiple sources of information, regularly reviewing your investments, and considering new information, perhaps even seeking out advice from trusted financial professionals. Moving on to herding behavior, which is the tendency for people to follow the crowd, even if it goes against their own best interests. This can lead to people investing in popular stocks or funds, even if they're overvalued and may not provide good returns in the future. You've probably heard of this being referred to before as the fear of missing out, or FOMO. There's a phrase in the investing world along the lines of, "If your taxi driver is recommending a stock, it's probably too late to invest in that stock." This is a popular notion used to describe the late stages of a stock market bubble. The idea behind this saying is that when the general public starts to invest in a particular stock, it's likely that the stock's price has already reached its peak and will soon start to decline. This is because the general public is often a late adopter of financial information and tends to invest only when a stock's price is already high,
thereby missing out on the best opportunities to buy low and sell high. The phrase is often used to emphasize the importance of doing your own research, seeking independent financial advice, and investing based on your own goals and risk tolerance, rather than following popular opinions or stock recommendations from non-experts. Loss aversion is the fear of losing money, which can lead people to hold on to losing investments for too long, instead of cutting their losses and moving on. This can lead to further losses and decreased returns in the long run. This bias is particularly relevant to investing because it can influence our investment behavior in a number of ways. For example, people may avoid taking risks in their portfolios because they are more concerned with not losing money than they are with maximizing returns. As a result, they may miss out on opportunities to grow their wealth over time. Similarly, people may be reluctant to sell losing stocks, even if it's the best financial decision, because they don't want to admit that they made a mistake or lock in the loss. A 1979 paper based on decisions under risk contributed to the concept that losses are approximately twice as powerful psychologically as the equivalent amount of gains. This can also lead to underperforming portfolios and missed opportunities for diversification. To mitigate the effects of loss aversion, it's important to have a long-term perspective and focus on the overall performance of a well-diversified portfolio, rather than getting too caught up in the short-term up and downs of individual investments. Additionally, having a written investment plan and sticking to it can help counteract impulsive decisions based on emotions and holding a losing position for far too long. Overconfidence can lead people to believe that they know more than they actually do, leading to bad investment decisions. It's important to remain humble and seek advice from trusted sources if needed. For example, an overconfident investor may be convinced that they know the future trajectory of a particular stock or market and make decisions based on that assumption. This can lead to poor investment decisions as the investor fails to account for the many variables and uncertainties that are inherent to the stock market. Overconfidence can also lead to excessive risk-taking. An overconfident investor may be more likely to invest a large portion of their portfolio in a single stock or sector, or take on excessive debt to fund their investments. This can put their entire portfolio at risk as they fail to consider or water down the possibility of significant losses. To avoid overconfidence bias, investors should take steps to educate themselves on the realities of investing and the many factors that can impact stock prices and market performance. Additionally, they should be open to seeking out the opinions of others and considering the perspectives of multiple sources. This can help reduce overconfidence and provide investors with a more well-rounded view of the market and their investments. Finally, investors should be mindful of their own emotions and take steps to avoid letting their confidence and optimism get the best of them. By adopting a disciplined approach to investing and avoiding impulsive decisions, investors can help to minimize the impact of overconfidence bias and improve their investment outcomes over time. In addition to avoiding psychological biases, it's important to stick to a plan and avoid impulsive decisions. Having a solid investment plan in place can help you stay focused on your long-term goals and avoid making hasty decisions based on emotions. This includes setting clear investment objectives, developing a diversified portfolio, and regularly reviewing and adjusting your investments as needed.
In conclusion, the psychology of investing plays a significant role in determining your investment success. By understanding and avoiding these biases and emotions that can negatively impact your investment decisions, and by sticking to a well-planned out strategy, you can make more informed decisions and increase the chances of reaching your financial goals. I hope this has been an informative video, and as always, I look forward to seeing you in the next one.